Hey guys, welcome back to Some Equals 41. As you know by now, I'm Wads. Thanks for joining me again today. I'm bringing you a deck profile, which is near and dear to my heart. I'm bringing you Dead Engine version 3, which I have dubbed Tokyo Rift. Now, this is very similar to the original build, but there are a few changes, and there are a few experiments in here, but every test that I've run so far, I seem to like the way that things are going. So, I'll kind of explain everything as I go, and we'll get started with all that. Alright, so we'll get started with the bot lineup. As you can see, this is our classic lineup with the SDCC promo, Cliff Jumper, Wave 2's Dead End, Drag Strip, and Prowl. As you know, Cliff Jumper, when you flip any of your cards over to bot mode, you draw a card, and my favorite thing to do with that is to flip Dead End here, because when you flip him, you draw a card again, so it's an easy plus too. It's just boom, boom, go ahead and take that. Not to say that I won't be flipping Drag Strip at some point too. I find that as I've refined the build a little bit, he's gotten a little bit more love with the flipping. Obviously when he attacks, you flip the orange and the blue, you get to draw two cards, which is what I'm aiming for most of the time, but you flip him over here, he's got that four with the Pierce one. And there's plenty of ways to take advantage of that. Bigger they are, all kinds of fun stuff, just so he can just lay down that pierce damage. And then last but not least, we've got Prowl over here on the side. 5 base attack, 10 health, 1 defense, natural, bold, 1. Nice big heavy hitter. But the thing that makes him even more important now is the introduction of Battle Masters, is when he's already dead, you can flip him over to KO and nab one of their weapons, and that'll be huge for knocking out someone's Lionizer or Aimless. Alright, so we'll go ahead and we're going to start with the actions next. We're going to start with the classic. We got 3 copies of Peace Through Tyranny, double pips. You don't usually play this all that often, because very rarely do I. If Prowl is tapped and crippled and I don't have anything to untap him, I might drop it and try and, you know, use 2 attacks to try and take something out. But for the most part, just running that for the double pips. Got 3 of the Start Your Engine, classic, Karn support. Flip everybody over, that way you can recycle Dead Ends, flip, untap that Prowl and have him swing again, get 2 nice big swings in with him. Following up, we got 3 Reckless Charge. As you can tell, very aggro deck, gives you the bonus 4. The feedback 3 can be bad, but we'll cover why that can be a good thing in a little bit. Got 3 supercharge in here still, love me some bold, and it's really good when taking advantage of Drag Strip because it gets you the extra chance to hit those blue and orange, and every time you can trigger Drag Strip, that's a great thing. After that, we got 3 copies of Roll Out, gives you that extra defense and the extra attack when you flip it, gives you the chance to flip everybody back over into alt mode. That way you can re-trigger Dead End again, keep drawing them cards. I mean, you know me, I love drawing cards with this deck. Next up, we got 3, the bigger they are. Got lots of small guys. You're going to run up against some big bots. That Pierce 4 is going to be huge. This was something Adam Eichberger told me about after he modded into the Micro Machines, and I've been using it ever since. Personally, very much love it. It's a great idea. Alright, next up, now this is brand new. I'm running 3 copies of Focus Fire, and I know that it seems like a bad idea sometimes. I discard them for green pips every now and then, but I find that the extra bolt is a good thing, because I don't always have that supercharge or that reckless charge drop down, and just having that extra one could mean the difference between a kill and not getting a kill. And I personally love dropping it. I haven't had a chance to drop all 3 of them in succession yet, but I have been able to drop 2, and it's basically like having an extra supercharge, and that extra damage can be game-making. And last but not least, I wish I had room for more than one, but I have 1 solo copy of I Still Function. I love I Still Function, period, in this deck. If I could fit 3 of them in, I would. I'm working on it, but as of right now, I only have 1 in the main deck. And we'll cover that, why that's so important, but more to the point, bringing back somebody, oh, I've already got 2 attacks because I've been untapping and they're out of guys. oh, I'm going to drop this and bring back my dead Prowl for another big swing along with, you know, three more. It's a great card. I personally love it. I just got my third copy barely 2 weeks ago. And, oh, man, it's probably my favorite card right now. So we're going to go ahead and scoop these up real quick and move on to upgrades. Now, there are more upgrade changes in this than there were actions. The actions more or less got changed around just a little bit, but didn't have a lot of Wave 3 inclusion. There is Wave 3 inclusion with the upgrades, and we're just going to kind of make our way through. We're going to start off with staple for aggro, 3 improvised shield, double pips, no stars, perfect choice, in my opinion. I think it's great staple for this deck. Another staple for this deck, obviously, I'm going to run 3 copies of turbo boosters, go with the classic untap, bonus plus 1, it's a utility so you can still drop weapons galore. Big fan and really good with all cars. Alright, next up we got 3 grenade launchers. Again, staple in an aggro deck, plus 4 orange pip for when you flip it. Huge, I love it. Big aggro, big attacks, big swings, just keep them going. Got 2 mining picks. I thought about adding a third, but with this build I couldn't justify it right now. I love it because I'm constantly drawing cards, so I'm always overstocked on things I don't want, including some constantly grabbing double pips, so it gives me something to throw on top of the deck. You stack 2, it's a bonus plus 3, and you're guaranteed double pips if you stack them. So, I mean, it's great. I love it. And it lets you stack those blues and oranges, too, if you're going to use drag strip so you can make sure he triggers. Always a good choice. I got 2 bashing shields. I had it down to 1 originally, and I couldn't justify having only 1 because I found that I needed it more frequently than I thought I would. I just wasn't getting it. So in this case, back up to 2, and it's working tremendously. Now we're going to get into the Wave 3 inclusions. There's 6 of them total. We got the first 3, 3 laser cutlass. Again, running so many small guys, this is a big, big improvement for them. The fact that they're now guaranteeing Pierce 3 when they have this means guaranteed damage. And then you flip over drag strip and equip him. Now he's got that, he's going to start with 5 Pierce 4 with his own inborn Pierce and natural attack. It's going to be a big, big deal, and I love it. And then last but not least, the other 3 we got, 3 eradication. I told you I want to run more ice belt function. I really do. I'm going to be working on it, trying to figure it out. Going above 41, really, I tried running 42. And it didn't work for me, so I trimmed that last card. It seems to have balanced off a little bit for now. But I'm going to figure out the formula, try and get another Ice Still Function into the main deck. But for now, I'm only going to run the 1. I love it with this because I'm going to call Prowl back up. I'm going to equip him with this. He's going to make a big swing. And then when he goes kaboom at the end of the turn, he's going to go take that spread damage. And it's going to be massive. And I love it, and it's just going to be crippling. Not to mention, you can put these on these little guys that are out here. They're getting one-shotted left and right anyways. They're giving all that feedback damage back. They're just like, oh, hey, you want to kill me? Boom, take it. Personally, huge fan of this card. I love it. Any deck where I'm running small guys, there's a good chance that I'm going to include at least 1, if not 2 of these. But it's all about balance, and right now, 3 of these in this deck gives a good balance. So that takes care of the main deck. If you guys are keeping score on your end, that's 41 cards, which is my signature, hence the title, Sum Equals 41, and I'm sure you're all aware by now. So let's go ahead and move over. We're going to check out the sideboard. And normally I don't build sideboards too often, but since this is my mainstay deck, I always try to keep it updated and try to keep it together. Go ahead and grab that from over here. Sorry for the changes and everything. My Nest went under heat warning, so I had to close it down for the season, so I'm in a different room until the weather starts to cool off later this year. Alright, let's get started. I've got sideboarded 2 copies, I Still Function. If I find that I need them, I can side them in. I'm making sure that they're there. I absolutely love this card, especially with the E-Grenades, getting that extra attack. I wish I could run all 3, but right now sideboarding 2 just in case I find something that's just not working. That's what I'm going with. I got 2 ramming speeds that used to be main decked. but for the most part, I find that I don't care a whole lot right now about back row hate. I got the bashing shields, which take care of most of my problems. I've got Prowl in case I run into weapon problems when he finally bites the dust, and that's pretty much where we're at. Alright, I got 3 copies of Confidence, and yes, when I sideboard out, I'll sideboard in all Autobots. I'll make sure to let you guys see the bot here in a second, I promise. Just being able to dig more is great for this deck. I don't get a whole lot of double actions, but being able to dig and then play, oh, that extra Eye Stealth function, and then drop that grenade on someone who's going to pop at the end of the turn, huge, love it, it's going to stick. And then last but not least, I was thinking about maining these, but I haven't found a way yet. I've got 3 copies of Heat of Battle. The Bold 3 is going to be good when I have a whole bunch of guys that are left to attack. I'm like, oh, I only get one action. Boom! Oh, you don't have any blue cards in your deck? That tough 3 doesn't do anything for you. So, here come my guys with Bold 3 apiece, and boom! It's just going to explode. Love it. Side decking it. Going to figure out a way to get it into the main deck at one point, but for now, sideboard is where it's going to stay. Now, the Heat of Battle and Confidence, I said this was going to be, I'm going to side into all Autobots. The Heat of Battle is going to be good, and if they're playing heavy blues, I might still side it in, and that's because I have sideboarding. Boom. Warpath. Not a car, but it's still good. Low health, I know, not great. Probably going to make a target of himself, but if I can get stuff rolling on, boom, no more tough. Now I'm dropping that Heat of Battle, boom, boom, getting all those attacks extra bold, and it shuts down your tough, and that's how we're going to take it. These guys are going to eat it. I don't know if this is going to work, but that's what I'm going with. The idea's there. I hope it's going to work, and that's pretty much where we're at with the sideboard. All right, I want to thank you all again for coming out to see me. Again, this deck, I'm going to have a photo of it here at the end. I'm going to have the whole thing spread out so you can take a look at it. If you guys are interested in seeing the actual deck list just written out so you can just read down through it, go ahead and pop a comment down here, throw up some likes, follow us on Facebook and on YouTube. We put out content quite often, and I'm going to try and get some videos out this week. You guys have a wonderful day and a wonderful week, and I will see you next time.